Google announced an exciting update to Jamboard that I'm going to demo for you in this video. And that is the ability to create custom backgrounds, which also means they will be locked backgrounds. So this feature is rolling out and you'll find it under Set Background. Now you're not stuck with the dots and the boxes. You have this image button. And when you click it, you're going to have all these different choices. I'm going to start with Google Image Search. Choose Set as Frame Background. And the neat thing I've noticed playing with this is that the Jamboard, unlike slides, instead of filling the screen, it automatically will resize things. Background, students could label the states. They could use the pen to trace the journey of Lewis and Clark. They could use the pen to draw different natural features, mountain ranges, rivers, and the like. Lots of possibilities here. I'm going to go to another slide and set the background. This time I want to do a coordinate grid. Instead of the image being distorted, it automatically adjusts for the Jamboard size. And if I was doing this whole class, I could come up here and go ahead and duplicate this slide and have a whole Jamboard full of this slide, or I could just go ahead and add a new slide. And then I have a blank slide and I can have a different background. Now, if you want to create custom backgrounds, you can still do that in Google Slide. So here's a blank Google slide. I'm going to go ahead and insert a table. Maybe this is going to be a sorting activity. And I did not change the slide setup here. It's at the default, this ratio. That seems to work fine. And then you can go ahead and download. I always download as a PNG. There it is. Go to my Jamboard, set background here, upload, and it's going to resize in there. And notice students cannot delete the background now. So if you're excited about this update, give this video a thumbs up and consider subscribing for future videos. Until next time, bye everyone.